Hey, hey, welcome back to the Conversion Clinic. In this video, I'm going to show you how I save over 10 hours every week with internal linking using AI. So I probably started out like you and, you know, went through your blog or pages and kind of like eyeballed it. You went through some text here and you're like, oh, that could go really nicely to another blog post that I have. You get the idea, right? You just eyeball it, you go through it, and you add as many internal links as you can, because you know that internal links is a great thing for SEO. And I started out doing this for the first like year or two, and then I'm like, oh, this is gonna be an easy way, you know, because I had clients coming in, we had hundreds of pages at that time, or thousands it must have been. Like right now, we've got over 100,000 pages for across all our clients, and so it's a big job, right? But anyway, I thought, okay, there's gotta be something easier. Now, Ahrefs only came out with its internal linking opportunities recently, like fairly new within the year or so, which has helped a lot. But before that, I moved on to Link Whisperer, right? Link Whisperer is a WordPress plugin, and basically it suggests the internal links that go through your website, and you can just confirm yes or no and edit it properly or whatever, which helps a lot. Like I had a lot of clients that didn't have WordPress as well. And so that made it quite difficult and we had to do it manually, right? We basically went and created a topical authority map. We created all the pages around it. And we're like, okay, let's link this one over to this one and this one over to this one. You know what I mean? And so you've got the map there and you kind of like eyeball it there. And then Ahrefs came out with this. I'm like, amazing, great. I can like do this for most of my clients. And then basically what you do is you just export it and send it to your web developer if you want to do it quickly, or you get your team to do it one by one. Now, the reason I'm telling you all of this is because this is how I used to do it, right? This is not the way I do it anymore. The reason that, thankfully I've moved on and found this new tool. The reason I've moved on from Link Whisperer is because one, not all my clients are on it. And two, I hate plugins. I try to get rid of plugins as much as possible because they're security risks and they slow down your website. Even though the tool says like it's asynchronous and you know it doesn't slow down your website, blah, blah, blah. There is a chance still, if you keep the plugin outdated and someone finds a vulnerability in that plugin, they can hack your website. Simple as that. If you didn't know, you know, you can thank me later. I found this tool and basically you insert the script into your site, just the header, and basically it finds all the same stuff what Ahrefs does and Link Whisperer. And it has the same capability of Link Whisperer where basically you can just scroll to the right and click accepted and it will insert the actual link. So this hypertext into your website itself. So you don't have to do it manually. So amazing, still saves time. But what I loved about this and what caught my eye was it really goes through and uses AI to see the semantic relevance of the actual suggested placement. So for example, instead of saying like running Google Ads, right? Instead of saying running Google Ads, which isn't really that helpful, it's giving more context around the link. Now, you could argue the same with this one, fractional CMOs, and we've got this one over here, fractional CMO, that's not very helpful, which you're right, it's not as helpful. But basically, I love that this suggests more ideas on capturing more words around the actual keyword itself. Because what I've found, and I've gone through this, and I've read up on this, but basically, Google's improving their technologies with NLP, and you can read this as well. I'm not going to pretend that I'm an expert in the actual models and things like that, but basically it's getting better at understanding the nuance of language. That's all it is, right? It's understanding like what words mean in certain orders and in different ways and when presented in this context or whatever. So it's getting better at that. It's a good idea, and John Mueller says this as well, it's a good idea to have context-rich links. So what this means is don't just focus on exact match anchor text. So exact match anchor text being what we found before, which is just fractional CMO. That's more like exact match, right? We want to move away from that and just start doing more context around it. So if I'm sending people to what is a fractional CMO, it shouldn't just say fractional CMO marked around it, because Google bot's gonna see agency is just right after this word and be like, I don't know if this is the right way to link to this other page. So Google's bots is coming through and it's kind of expecting you to like give it a little hint before it goes and clicks away to this page to see what's linked to it, whatever. The idea here is for the keyword text here, or the text that you're gonna link to, it's better for you to say like, give the bot a hint. What is a fractional CMO? That's a big hint, because that just goes to a page about what is a fractional CMO. So it's highly relevant to the page, right? There are clever ways of doing it. You can be like, do you wanna learn what a fractional CMO does? And you can link that whole thing and send it to a page on what is a fractional CMO. And it tells the bot and gives it a stronger context which is what everyone is saying and what Google is kind of understanding around nuance of language, which improves your SEO much, much higher. And then Ahrefs and SEMrush are indicating basically that if you can focus on doing this with all your internal linking and giving it more context, you actually boost your SEO rankings more than just using exact match. Fact check me on this, please, and just go through your own studies as well. Do that kind of stuff. Basically, I'm using this. That in a nutshell, I'm using this. This is saving me a bunch of time. Now, it's not perfect. It's still got like fractional CMOs and whatever, but it's basically, I just go through, I look at the relevance and then accept. I can go to the actual page level and like, for example, this one here, it's got 11 opportunities. It's for dental marketing Perth, and it's trying to go to a how to choose, like it's a blog post. Okay, cool. And then it's giving me suggested placement, but it's giving me the same link over here. So I'd probably only choose one or two max and then move on to another one. But it's really, really cool in that way. And it connects to your Google Search Console. And I love that it's not a plugin. I love that I can just connect heaps of my client websites. Anyway, that's how me and my team save tens of hours every single week, because we have hundreds of thousands of pages. And so it's nice to add value to the client and save time while working on other SEO activities as well, like writing blog posts, creating local based landing pages, adding LSI keywords, improving content. So this saves a bucket load of time. And I hope this was super helpful. Check it out. Like, it might not work for you, right? But it's working for me. So I hope that helps. If you've got any questions, leave them in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.